Hello, I'm Dr. Nick Delgado. I'm with Beatrice Delgado, and we're talking about your life. We're talking about your energy levels, whether you're struggling with being overweight, if you're having trouble with your skin, such as acne or even just pimples and breakouts, or possibly you're even concerned about cancer, heart disease, chronic diseases such as high blood pressure, diabetes, arthritis. You know, you and I have dealt with this for, I've been in the profession for over 40 years,
yes.
And I think you had an introduction to the program by me years ago. I think I'd come home after a seminar and talk to you about it. So tell me a little bit about how you got involved and what you learned over the last more than nearly 40 years of working in what I call lifestyle medicine, herbal, supplemental intervention, and hormonal balance. So tell me about it.
Well, when you first introduced me to changing my diet, you opened up the refrigerator one day and threw out all my goodies.
What were the goodies?
Oh, mayonnaise, butter, cheese, bologna, chicken meat.
I said bologna to the bologna?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, there was a lot of bologna in our house. That's right.
Wow.
But yes, I was shocked, and I didn't really believe you, Nick, until I went to the speaking engagement you had, and you presented the slides. I was impressed on the information on the slides and all your knowledge. So I started changing my eating habits, first of all, and that's how I think you started out as your career in your dietary approach, and then as a scientist, you developed supplements to help us along. So I've been very blessed.
Well, let me ask you this. If I understand correctly, I was breastfed,
yes,
as an infant, and I was mucho gordo. I was very fat, very heavy as even an infant.
Yes.
What were the comments? And I heard I used to rock on the middle of the floor like Buddha. I was so heavy. And I had long hair too, I think. But tell me about that.
No. Oh, well, you were born with long hair and the nurses combed it like Elvis Presley.
But my anyway, dad had a hairstyle,
yes,
of Elvis Presley.
Yes,
my,
yes,
dad, Nick. Yeah.
Yes, right. But I remember having a picture of you in a little bouncing chair, and you had a bottle. By then, it was regular formula. You were about 15 months because you were breastfed a long many months. But I think it's because we gave you such a high dairy product for your bottle that you kept just maintaining that heavy fat.
Okay, so maybe I genetically had a tendency to,
yes,
hold fat around my belly,
the thighs. We had to buy husky jeans.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I used to wear husky jeans.
That's
when,
right,
I was 12 years old.
That's right.
I had to make weigh-ins for Pop Warner football, which,
yeah,
was a struggle for me,
yeah,
to drop from nearly 150 pounds, yeah, at 5'8" as a maybe an 11 year old, I guess, mm-hmm, 11 or 12, and I had to get down to 115 pounds, mm-hmm, I remember, in,
mm-hmm,
less than a few months, I guess it was.
Yeah.
So that was a struggle for me. I definitely remember that. So I used to go to my dad's beer tavern and,
mm-hmm,
eat.
Yeah.
I enjoyed eating the big sandwiches, and I always want to emulate my dad, so I eat a lot of steak.
Yeah.
You didn't serve us hardly any sugar. I think you were educated by Emmy McMaster, so you did use whole foods and like whole grain pancakes,
yes,
and fruit and vegetables. I remember spinach and even eating liver, but we always had a big serving of meat and eggs, right?
Yes, oh yes. I was raised on a cereal in the morning, which was very beneficial, but I didn't realize that, so I was
A whole grain cereal of some type? Oatmeal?
Oatmeal, mostly oatmeal, yeah.
Uh-huh.
But I fix breakfast for my kids. Eggs and bacon and ham and potatoes, fried potatoes. So I thought I was doing a good job.
Mm-hmm.
But in the long run, after finding out all the problems of such a high-fat diet and high cholesterol diet, I created, we had a lot of health problems growing up, yeah.
Mm.
In fact, I think you had some kind of a stroke when you were in your 19 or 20 years old. So.
Yeah, ever since I was age 15, I had high blood pressure, mm-hmm. and the doctor put me on blood pressure medications. So during my entire high school years, leading up to my first 2 years at USC in college, I had high blood pressure and I was on blood pressure medications. And still I suffered on a Thanksgiving morning a TIA, a transient ischemic attack. I remember my blood pressure, I was hospitalized once, it went over 300, over 120. And, you know, I just didn't know what was going on. The doctor said, just calm down and relax. I thought, I wasn't really, you know, all stressed out or anything. And he said, don't eat salt. We weren't using salt, if I remember.
No, right.
But it was coming from the thickness of my blood. Now, it's interesting that, you know, so many people right now are enamored with these keto diets, eating a lot of fat and butter and eggs and meat and cheese and avoiding.
And a high-protein diet.
Yeah, it's very high-protein.
Yes.
So what's your thought about that right now?
Well, high protein, as far as I have learned from you, it draws the minerals out of your bones to neutralize this high protein, because the body isn't expecting such a high protein intake.
So osteoporosis is the first chronic disease that we suffer, loss of calcium, magnesium, zinc out of the bones.
And I was going to say that the elderly break their hip and then they fall. It's not because they fell and broke their hip, because we're all programmed for a high protein diet with all the advertisement.
Yeah.
And that's the worst thing we can do.
Well, they say Robert Atkins, the famous Atkins diet that started the initial high protein, high animal-based diet, he slipped and fell in New York, they said, on an icy pavement and hit his head and had a stroke. But in post autopsy, it's shown that he had complete blockage of his coronary arteries leading to the heart and to the brain. And so it's most likely he had a stroke and then fell.
Yeah.
Certainly, it's interesting that there's cultures around the world and the highest incidence of cardiovascular disease, stroke. I just looked up, the number one country in the world for cancer is Mongolia. And they eat a lot of meat and dairy product and eggs and goat and cheese. And they use a non-fat milk, but they use a lot of butter and creams and soups and things. A lot of spices. The spices aren't the problem. It's interesting that you look at these cultures and they suffer from chronic diseases at a much higher incidence. Now, the cultures that eat a lot of vegetables and fruit and whole grains and beans and peas, much of which is being attacked right now by the keto and paleo communities, these are the blue zones. These are the people that live the longest. They have, they thrive. People say, well, they exercise more, but maybe they exercise more because they're able to, because they eat so healthy. And their base diet, like the longest lived people in the world, Okinawa, eat a lot of sweet potatoes and oranges and fresh fruits and vegetables. And it's been said they eat pork, but they eat pork only a few times a month. They eat fish only a few times a month. Now, more recent introductions of the Western diet in Japan and Okinawa and around the world, these cultures are starting to lose their edge. They're not living as long as they used to due to fast food introduction and the belief that they need to eat more protein, which is generally animal protein.
Yes.
So I think a plant-based protein diet is a good idea, but let's come back full circle, because a lot of people are gonna argue that it shouldn't be oil-free, it shouldn't be whole food, fruit, vegetable, bean and pea, that there's lectins in beans. All you have to do is cook the beans and it gets rid of the lectins. So there's a number of things and arguments that we can get into a whole story on that, but at what point was your turning point that you realized, and how long did it take you to make that change in your diet? And how long have you adhered to a diet? And at times when you fell off, did you notice a difference?
A lot of questions there all at one time. So let me see. When I took it, the taste buds take a while to adjust, because you're used to that high fat and that taste, you know, it's really strong. And so it takes about, what, 2 or 3 months for your taste buds to change. So that's a bit, not a very long time. But once I started changing my eating habits and more of a complex carbohydrate and a lot of fruit and a lot of vegetables.
A lot of natural fibers, what they call starch-resistant carbohydrates.
Beans and whole brown rice. I've started feeling a lot better. more active.
How old were you when you were feeling better? You went from a pretty high animal-based protein diet. You were working at that time in secretarial type work and accounting. Mm-hmm. And then did you lose a little weight? Was there changes in your body and in your energy?
No, you know, I've always had a little trouble getting exercise in. So
we're working on that now. We just moved the treadmill into your room. And by the way, I want the audience to know you turn 84 this week.
Not yet.
October 9th.
No.
14th.
17th.
October 17th.
So I got a few days to go. But dancing would be great. If I could only go dancing during, you know, all day long, I would lose a lot of weight. I'm not too overweight, but it would help to get rid of a little bit of the panza, you know.
Right.
But I think I started probably around 40 years old, really watching what I was eating. In fact, I would take pita bread sandwiches to work filled with spaghetti or vegetables, and the girls there would say, "What are you eating today?" You know, and they would make, you know, little comments and everything. But pretty soon, some of them were starting to take a hint and changing their eating habits. So, probably around 40, I started, and I was very careful. Even my sister, we went out to dinner one time, and I was very careful even in ordering at a restaurant. And I'd ask the waiter, "Does it have this? Does it have that? Would you eliminate the cheese or the sour cream and maybe just a lot less oil?" And my poor sister was so embarrassed. She said, "I'm never going out to eat with you again." But anyway, so you experience a lot of interesting situations because of the drastic change in my eating habits. But it's paid off, Nick. 84 years old, and I don't take medications. No arthritis. None of the regular things that all my friends have experienced through the years.
So over 40 years, and you've maintained overall a good level of health. Mm-hmm. Like anyone, you've had some setbacks and incidences come back and to work through to help yourself to kind of recover or come back or work through. And at the same time, at what point did you start getting oriented about herbal natural supplements and supporting your hormones, your adrenal glands, and overall your thyroid and some of the other important things that as we age, these hormones decline? Yeah. And what have you been doing and about what point did that start? About 20 years ago or longer?
Yes, I believe. Is that when you started the supplements? At that time, actually, I was taking all of your products, adrenal DMG, the Estroblock, Lean and Fit, all the powders, the Slim Blend,
protein,
Stem Cell Strong, and now your new Beat Vitality is excellent. So I have that every morning in my powders, in my vegetable drink, and the supplements along the day as you have prescribed, and it's a great program.
Do you use Testrogenesis cream?
No.
Okay. So the use of NeuroInsight and NeuroInspire.
Yes. Uh-huh.
So that's for cognitive brain function?
Right. Okay. So that's...
Yeah. And I'm just wondering, too, overall, does it make sense for you with using trace minerals to support your health, that taking these supplements combined with a healthier diet, and of course, do you notice a difference in your energy and well-being? How much sleep do you need, and when do you wake up? How does that all work for you?
Well, I'm a morning person. I wake up anywhere between 4 and 5 o'clock, and I'd like to retire about 8 o'clock, latest 9 o'clock, and I have good sleeping habits, so that's been a blessing.
So when you wake up, are you energized? You alert? I mean, how do you feel most mornings?
I mean, I get out of bed like ready to go hit the road.
So is it sundown, sunrise? Is that close to?
Right. Well, I'm up with the chickens.
Yeah, mm-hmm. that's about right. Mm-hmm. I mean, most people should be on some kind of circadian rhythm cycle, mm-hmm. and you're pretty consistent with that. Mm-hmm. So when you are embarking on a kind of a natural progression to deal with aging and wellness, I guess that next evolution is to kind of pinpoint certain symptoms. So I know at our website, DelgadoProtocol.com, we have a symptom-related questionnaire, a quiz for thyroid, mm-hmm. cortisol, testosterone, estrogen, and we're continuing to add more support information.